Large blue ATMs have been popping up across Nairobi, but they're not dispensing cash. Instead, they give out clean cooking fuel. The locally produced ethanol is both good for the environment and safer to use than traditional wood or kerosene, says Michael Wakoli, head of fuel operations at three-year-old company Koko.
I am using the waste of the product that was used to make sugar and molasses and so on to create something that I can still reutilize it again and recycle it. So all in a way to try and also meet up with the climatic requirements we have now, the climatic conditions now we've known we have destroyed quite a bit of our forest coverage and so on and so forth.
Ethanol from agricultural waste is a greener alternative to using charcoal made from cutting down trees. The United Nations Environmental Programme also says sugarcane bioethanol can reduce emissions by 40 to 62% compared to petroleum-derived fuels. But for Faith Morar, one of Koko's around 200,000 customers, it's also about cost. A litre of kerosene in Nairobi costs just under 111 shillings, or approximately $1. But Koko sells a litre of its biofuel for just under 78 shillings. And the dispensers allow customers to fill up with smaller amounts using mobile money services.
It's really helped me because cooking gas costs me 1,000 Kenya shillings to refill, but with Koko, I can get even 100 shillings worth of fuel.
Kenya has given ethanol producers, like Koko, who use sugar processing waste, an exemption from its 16% VAT. That's to encourage ethanol production to grow in tandem with the sugar industry, one of Kenya's common crops. Koko plans to expand to 10 other Kenyan towns in the near future. And the potential market is huge. Around 900 million people do not have access to clean cooking fuel, the United Nations says. The World Health Organization warns that's contributing to air pollution that causes hundreds of thousands of premature deaths on the continent each year.